Hi guys, welcome to this tutorial. Today we will be creating a search bar and with searching function. So now I have created a list of string with this hi, hello, happy, hell, owl, something like that. And then this is our search bar. When I key in something and press the search icon, it will filter and show me the result, and this is how it works. So now let's build it from scratch. I'll explain it one by one. Okay, now. So let's make all the widgets to be at center, and then we need to have a search bar. So the search bar will be in text field, and there are few parameters we need to specify in the text field. First, we need to specify the controller, and the controller will be text editing controller. We need to define it, and let's name it as search controller. And so we need to place it at here, and then this is our initial loops. Now we need to make it look nicer, so we should modify the decoration. So for the decoration for the text field is input decoration. And in the input decoration, we can add something like border and label and so on. So I would like to add label text to be like shush. Okay, it looks up, but it's, I want to add some padding between it. So let's swap it with controller. And put some padding. Okay, and then it still doesn't look nice, so I want to warp the text field with card so that I can adjust the border shape. So I have specified the elevation, and then shape I will be using rounded rectangle border, which I can specify the border radius, make it like 5. Okay, here's the result, but this is an underline below the search bar, so I will remove it by adding the border input border dot none. Okay, so here's our initial looks. So I want to add an icon at the right side of the search bar. So input decoration suffix icon. Search. Okay, it looks good. So now let's continue with the functionality within it. So we need to create a function called filter. and it will return string value. So in the filter, in this function, it will check. First, we need to declare an array of a list of a string first. Let's copy this. Okay. So first, it will check if the word, the string contain the text in the search bar. So string, let's create a loop and loop through this list and set a and we set a condition checking that if the string does contain the text inside the search controller. So search controller dot text. If yes, we need to store the string in the variable. So let's declare a variable first. Let's name it as result. Let initialize it first, otherwise it will have error afterward. So result. We need to stack the result. Let's put a comma between it, make it nicer. So, and then after looping, let's return the result. Okay, here it goes. So, while we are clicking this icon, we need to, the shift icon, we need to call this filter function. So, let's add a gesture detector to detect all the movement in this icon. So the movement, the action that I want to detect is on tap. So during the on tap, I will call this filter function and then it will tell me to filter all the words and tell me the result. So where to show the result? So let's wrap this as column and then show the result at 0. Let's use the text and then result at the and add a function. Okay, so on tap, for every state change, the filter will be called here. So we don't need to call the filter here. So we just need to change the state. So set state, let it just be empty. So the state will be changed and then the UI will look different. Let's see. Now it become at the top of the pages because we didn't specify the x6. Then exit size, let's set it to minimum. Now it show all the text because we didn't filter it. So we need to filter it at the top of the function. If the search controller is the text of the search controller is now, then we return maybe no value. Yeah. Then we check again if the result is also now, then we return the now value. Yeah. So okay, now the result is now. So when we type in something like hash, it will show me all the related words. So like he, it will show hello and hell. So something like this. If we have empty,